Hello and welcome back to the Philly and Plays YouTube channel. Today we're going to be building my interpretation of a Tachi frigate from my favorite sci-fi show next to Firefly, which I have thoughtfully named the No Tachi Mark II, because it can be a slippery little devil. Mark I was a little closer to the geometry of some of the artwork out there, but I decided to deviate a bit for the sake of gameplay and my own personal tastes. Stay to the end of the video for some alternate versions. I actually enjoy playing with this one in-game more than any of the other ships I've made thus far. As we begin, I'd also like to humbly request that you hit that subscribe button, as I'm making an earnest effort to hit 1,000 subscribers and justify the time it takes to make these videos. Thank you very truly for that. Also, please excuse my voice, as I've been annoyingly rather ill this week. Alrighty, so the build uses endgame C-class components and should cost you around 600k. Obviously, feel free to pause the video as we go and make whatever alterations suit your personal tastes. Depending on which version you go with, some components you may have to get from Star Yards. Best bet is to always start out at one of your outpost shipbuilder pads and then supplement from there. So we're going to start out with a ladder access landing bay of your choice, in this case a Hope Deck 4. Then we'll add a 3x1 that will be the entry point with an optional Hope 5 landing gear and Nova weapon mount. Behind that, add a 2x1 with two Aculander 11s or similar, and some shielded cargo if desired. Next, add Deimos bumpers fore and aft, with Nova NG-15 landing gears between them, and some cargo if desired. I decided to add Hope 55 landing gears as well, because I think they look cool and they provide 4 lander thrust each, meaning less gear are needed. For the next tier, add a 2x1 with 3 1x1s forming a T-shape. Surround the HABs with Deimos wings, Echo, and Delta. Cockpit at the front, weapon mounts on the sides, you can add the weapons later, and the largest reactor graph driver helium tank you can manage at the rear, in this case, an SF-40 reactor. Directly behind that, add another of your core components, in this case a JS-52 jump drive. It is imperative to the design that this component have attachment points on all sides. Add some additional shielded cargo to this as well. Moving to the rear of the ship, we're going to add a Sexton 10ST to the base, followed by the 900 helium tank, with more shielded cargo. Above the helium tank, add a Deimos Hull Alpha as a bridge between the main hull and the engines. For engine configurations, I erred on the side of nominal performance, but there's a lot more accurate looks and options you can do instead. For this build, I used a Dun 31 over top of an SAE 5660, another 10ST at the base, and the whole ensemble flanked by two Supernova 2200s with Taiyo braking engines. Back at the front of the ship, we're going to add another 2x1 HAB with a Deimos Hull Alpha and Deimos Cowling 4. Place two Galleon S203 cargo holds with weapon mounts over top the previous level 1x1s, and add some Deimos bumpers on either side of the cargo holds. For the final touch, we're going to add the Deimos 110DP docker in between two Deimos Cowling 4s to cover up the reactor. Behind them, you can add the Deimos Spine Charlie and Echo with weapon mounts. And finally, the shield. Now for weapons, I went for the full PDC ballistic turret route. If you're interested in that, it is 3 Mahler 106T autocannon turrets, 4 Jishaku FERF rapid railgun turrets, and 4 Jishaku NDRF rapid railgun turrets. Now, if you want to be a little more true to the concept, it's really fun to place particle beam cannons at the front to simulate the spinal mounted railgun, and you can swap another weapon set out for torpedoes. Now, for the Mark I variant, I didn't have the Hope Deck 5 landing gears or the front landing gear, but instead had 4 Hope Deck 6 gears along the base, as well as some tastefully colored cargo along the rear. I went through a series of different engine configurations, such as White Dwarf 2030s, or basing everything off of a single Supernova, but none of them looked quite right to me. And there we have it, my gameplay versions of the Rocinante or Tachi frigate. I look forward to seeing what everyone does with it. I'm sure there's thousands of variations out there. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know in the comments what you think and what ships or ideas you'd like to see next. Until next time, I'll see you around the verse.